Guys, Andrew here.
Caleb
and Matt.
Welcome to another episode of the LCR podcast.
Lights, camera, reaction. I'm going to take a giant swig of water.
Episode 55.
55.
55.
Can't wait till we get to 350, so that way I can be like, I can just make up the story and be like, you know, there was one day I was walking down the street, and this little girl fell off her bike, and she skinned her knee. So I ran to her and like, little girl, are you okay? And she's like, yeah, I think I just need a Band-Aid. But I don't have any money to buy one. And I'm like, oh, okay, well, how much do you need? And she's like, I need about 350. Well, it was about damn time I realized that it was a fucking four-legged, 60-foot-tall creature from the Mesozoic period. And I said, God damn it, Dr. Marshall, you get the hell out of here.
And that was the Lights, Camera, Reaction podcast, guys.
We'll see you at episode 350.
I think you're going to make the easy 420 joke.
Yeah.
Or episode 69.
Oh, that's gonna be a
that's
coming up.
Can we just?
It's gonna be the sex podcast.
Hold on. You guys keep talking. I wanna.
We have to do it like upside down.
Just our faces by the end of it, just completely red. We just pass out.
Dude, people would love that. We would wear shorts. They see all our legs. Or the cameras under the table when we're upside down.
We just talk and just our legs just keep moving as we talk. All right, we're doing something. The theme for the 69th podcast.
I feel like.
What's this podcast about? Do you guys know? Probably not.
Little bit of Bad Boys.
Little bit of Bad Boys at
the
very end.
Podcast is called.
But this is going to be a good old fashioned news podcast. News. We got your
be short and sweet.
We got some video games. We got some SAGs. We got some box office. We got some film and TV news, and then we'll talk about Bad Boys, and then talk about what's just going on in our lives. And I want to kick it off with video games because. After the high that we got of
Doom,
the Doom video,
Doom.
And our 800 sub celebration, I was like, you know what, we should just talk about some damn video games.
Speaking of video games, follow us on Twitch,
Adam Evo Plays.
twitch.tv/AdamEvoPlays.
So, kind of like, I guess we'll start with some worry news that I think it was last week, 3 games got delayed.
Yeah.
We got Cyberpunk, which is now slated for September 17th. War. And then rumor is, I guess there is an online, but it won't be available until 2021.
That's what I heard.
So I don't really know. What would the online insist?
Focus on story.
Would it kind of be like Red Dead? That's like really the only like online I could imagine.
Maybe. I feel like, I don't know. I feel like just hopefully they do it better than Red Dead.
But I wonder why they are. I mean, it was supposed to come out in April or May. So it's only a few months, but that's okay.
I mean, honestly,
save my money for a little bit longer.
Yeah, with how big of an undertaking this looks like with like, you know, graphics and everything, I can understand that they need, you know, a couple more months to just polish off. Mm-hmm.
And it's not like when a movie gets delayed, it's like, oh, fuck this. It's getting reshoots. It's going to be awful.
Yeah.
When a game gets delayed, it's like, okay, they're going to polish it. They're going to make it better. So like when a game gets
getting reshoots.
Yeah, when a game gets delayed, it's going to be hopefully better. Yeah.
There is a famous Miyamoto quote, a delayed game is good eventually. A rushed game is bad permanently. Or something like to that extent.
Wise words.
Mm-hmm.
But then another game that got delayed, not that crazy, just about a month or so, Final Fantasy VII Remake, people are pissed.
Not really. It's like a month. It's like, yeah, half
it's like
half.
A month, but like people were, because like, there was like a rumor of a demo coming out. Mm-hmm. And then that demo, they never knew when that demo was going to come out. And now the game got pushed like a month. So they're wondering if the demo is going to be released on the day that the game was supposed to come out. Who knows? Anybody here play Final Fantasy VII?
Nope, I'm excited to finally see it because that game has been hidden for so long. It's been in somewhat of a development hell.
Yeah.
And people just want their character for freaking hands on it.
And it's the fact that it's pretty much a new style.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
From the which entices me. I've never played a Final Fantasy game. And, you know, this is the one that you go to, Final Fantasy mm-hmm. VII. So I definitely want to play it.
There's a bit of some backlash with how it's structured because it's in now a chapter system.
Yeah.
This isn't the full game that's coming out. It's the first chapter, which is like the first 5 hours of the first game.
But like
5 to 10 hours, but it's going to be like
45 bucks, right? Which is a little much.
I think maybe, but they're arguing that it's much bigger and it's going to be like a 40, 80 hour game.
Yeah, like, which is cool if that's the case. It just sucks that, yeah, like, at the end of it, it's going to be like episode 2, 2021. You're just like, oh. I could have maybe just waited for the whole game.
I just bought it today, and I already beat it.
But,
a quick side note. April 24th, when the LCR
we're still doing 7.69
is going to be either Antebellum or Bad Trip.
Or
Antlers, because the week before, it's a limited release, so that could be when Antlers is
viewable. Or just the Sex Podcast.
The Sex Podcast. Not your daddy's LCR podcast. We're
stuff up our butts.
Oh, my God.
And then two more games. This one, not that crazy, that's what I'll say. The Iron Man VR game. David and I got to test it out at the PlayStation Experience at Ace Comic Con back in October. That was pretty cool.
Is that your first VR experience?
It was my first VR experience.
And you didn't tell us until now?
Sorry, guys. Like, I didn't get to play it for that long, but it was fun. But, I mean, it's VR. It's not going to be that long, and it's not my
Not the big Iron Man game that we thought we were getting.
Yeah, no, it's not like Rocksteady's version of it, which would be fucking dope. Like, if Rocksteady would make another game, it would have to be like Iron Man, because then you could just upgrade his gear.
That'd be awesome.
Like Batman.
Can't wait for Marvel's Avengers to come out. See if that's actually a good game or not.
Yeah. Well, then that's the last one that got delayed. Sweet. Marvel Avengers also got delayed to a September 4th slate. Also Square Enix. So I don't know if they're having trouble right now. Both of their games got delayed. Kingdom Hearts got delayed a little bit last year. So it just seems like their games just always are getting delayed more recently.
Maybe they just have a lot of
like stuff on their plate or something.
That
well, goodbye, Matt.
This always happens.
I want to lean back. And just sitting, anyway, I feel like they're just like too eager, so they don't know how to properly slate their games for release. You know?
Yeah.
Because like,
they project something and then they're like, "Fuck, we need like 6 more months."
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or the real reason is because they're working on Geno for Smash.
Or that. Which I guess is a good segue into my next video game topic.
I just knew it. I felt it. I knew it was coming.
Smash released their newest character and the last for this year, first and last of this year. Who is that?
Well, we might get more.
Yeah. Well, who's this one?
Byleth from Fire Emblem Three Houses, which I have not played yet, but is a very successful game. I've heard nothing but great things.
Is it out yet?
The character?
Yeah.
No. 28th.
Okay.
And that's when you can pre-purchase the second Fighter Pass, which is giving us a whopping, not 5, but 6 characters.
And so I bring the discussion to the table. Who would you want to be?
That for
who would you want these characters to be? Obviously, my easy pick would be Sora as a character. That'd be a lot of fun.
I guess a lot of people don't want Sora.
Don't?
Like, there's a very passionate, I want it, I don't want it.
I think it's just a love-hate thing. But
if Kingdom Hearts is coming to the Switch, it's kind of obvious to do that.
Mm-hmm. And I think it's a fun character because I think of like his moves he could have, his special, like he can have like his ultimate form be like his special like ability.
What's your special?
Like the different colors could just be his different outfits that he has. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I just think of a lot of stuff. There's a lot of variety with him. He has different keyblades he could use, pull out, stuff like that. So
someone made the joke that was like, he's not another sword wielder because it's a keyblade. It's like, it's a sword.
It's a sword.
It's a blunt object that he swings around.
But what about you guys? Who would be a character you'd want to see?
Surprised you didn't say Waluigi.
I mean, that's just a fucking meme. It's never going to happen.
It is confirmed that the character's already picked.
Okay, all so, 6 are.
Mm-hmm, there's okay. No... Everyone on Twitter, calm your fingers down. All your begging and pleading is going to change anything. So if they're already
picked... But like, it could have been one of the people that they're begging for.
True.
Mm-hmm. So they're not doing the voting system or...
They could be picking from the old voting system, but they didn't do a new one. The last one was for Smash 4, which is where we got Bayonetta from, apparently. And
Cloud, right?
Cloud? No. I think he was just a pure business move.
Okay, fair enough.
You met? You got anybody? I guess I'll show a picture of what Geno looks like, since you guys don't know what he is.
I would think
that's what Geno looks like.
Hmm.
He's from Super Mario RPG.
Okay, yeah.
Which would make sense if they're making an HD remaster of it. Would be perfect time to drop him for it.
I'd be interested to see another character from Metal Gear Solid, like Revolver Ocelot or even Psycho Mantis.
Oh. Psycho Mantis was... No. Who was the guy in Brawl that was in Sistrophe? He had the mask on with, like, the dot, and he had, like, a techno-y sword.
Fuck.
You know who I'm talking about, though?
Yes.
Didn't, like, a Metal Gear crush him in one of the games?
I think he was in...
Do you know what I'm talking about?
Revengeance.
Revengeance. Oh.
Probably if I saw a picture, I know what I'm Raiden? Talking about.
No, not Raiden.
Assist trophy? Oh, I'm getting somewhere. Gray Fox. That guy.
Yes.
And he yeah.
You can buy his helmet.
Oh, for how much? $5?
$200.
Ooh, close enough.
Pretty close.
Already got Banjo. That's still freaking crazy. Ooh.
That Banjo got on there?
Paper Mario is a popular choice.
Ooh, which that would be a good
choice. Because it's super unique. It's another Mario, but it's a totally different Mario. It's not like Mario and Dr. Mario. It's totally different. He's got a hammer. His side specials, or his specials could be his partners from the games. And that would make perfect sense if the rumors are true that we are getting a new Paper Mario game.
Yeah, not like a remaster, like a brand new one.
Or a remaster, honestly.
Dude, just do a new one.
If they could do 1 and 2 into a combo pack, because I haven't played the first one, remaster the first one?
Dude, I fucking love playing.
Sorry.
Goodness. I love playing Paper Mario so much. That was a fun game to play.
Yeah.
I would freak out. That is one of my all-time favorite games of all time. So
of all time.
If we do get a true sequel, none of this stupid sticker star crap, color splash, Super Paper Mario is fun. But that was most a more spin-off-y game than the rest. But yeah, regular RPG mechanics.
So that wouldn't be a bad one. Paper Mario would be fun.
Good writing, art style. Give us partners back. Dude, Goombella, Koops.
What are you looking up?
I'm just looking at
Bobbery.
So you know how we were talking about Squadron 42?
Oh yeah. Do you know about this?
No.
So last night, how did I stumble upon? Oh, because Ben Mendelsohn, isn't it? We were watching the third episode of The Outsiders, and I was looking at Ben Mendelsohn's filmography, and it showed he was slated for a movie called Squadron 42, and I click on it, and it's like a virtual game, but it has like Gary Oldman, Mark Hamill, Mark Strong, Ben Mendelsohn, Henry Cavill. I'm like, what the fuck is this game? Well, I thought it's a movie, and I was like, what the fuck is this movie?
Is this
like
a VR game where I get to make out with all these people?
it's a game. Yeah. Go ahead, talk about it.
So it's, I don't know if you guys have ever heard of the game Star Citizen.
No.
It's a pretty big game, I think. I've never played it. It's a PC game. And it's under the genre of space trading and combat first person shooter, and then Squadron 42 is a story based single player campaign which is set in the Star Citizen fictional universe. It is supposedly a spiritual successor to Wing Commander.
Okay.
But Caleb is now looking at photos.
Okay, Gary, I see you, Gary. That did not look like Mark Hamill for a second.
It's really weird. Like,
wow. Yeah, so there's not... I don't really know a
whole lot about this game.
But apparently it's supposed to come out this summer.
That's right.
Like, late summer.
Did Liam Cunningham? The Onion Knight?
There's a lot of people in it. It's pretty crazy. And we just stumbled upon this last night when I was like, when did Ben Mendelsohn become famous? And then I saw this, and I was like, huh, I have no idea what this is. So look up Squadron 42.
That's beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There's a perfect background picture in one of those. That is a
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Amazing. Oh, it's in the new Star Fox game. That's what it is.
But so Squadron 42. Look it up. Support it. Give it some buzz, maybe, so this game will come out so we can watch it.
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
But Smash.
Smash. We all love it. Three characters so far. Got any more? Master Chief, Steve from Minecraft, and Shrek. There you go.
Steve from Minecraft would be really cool.
That's a big one.
That's a big one.
Especially with the whole cross-platform thing.
Yeah, that'd be a fun one to have.
Still iffy on it.
You are?
Yeah. I could see it happening. I could see it not happening.
But
Master Chief, I could totally see. Because Nintendo and Xbox, Microsoft are really friendly right now. And that would be basically our next Snake, like this gen Snake.
Yeah.
Because like before, it's like, Snake can't be in Smash Bros. Have you seen that ass? Those grenades.
It'd be cool to
violence.
Get Crash. Isn't Crash on Switch?
Mm-hmm.
So it'd be cool Crash. To have Crash Bandicoot.
I would love Crash or Spyro. Yeah. Crash is definitely more likely to happen.
Crash is more of a fighting character.
Oh, yeah.
He looks like more like he would be easier to maneuver than Spyro, but both would be cool.
Did Spyro be cool because then he could glide around and whatnot?
Oh, yeah. But, it'd be cool to have him and then, like, he can like wear the mask at one point or like pull out like a TNT box, Nitro box, you know, stuff like that.
I was thinking of Master Chief again, sorry. What could his final smash be?
For a Crash?
Yeah.
Whoa. Maybe Fake Crash shows up. I don't know. That could be a skin though, Fake Crash.
Oh yeah. That's one thing that does need to happen in Smash. Not all we have alternate colors. If we could have alternate costumes. Like, legit costume.
Because, like, what if, like, Mario, I don't know, maybe he does. Like
Mario has, like, two. He's like, got Builder Mario and Wedding Mario Super Mario Odyssey, which is...
Why not the raccoon Mario, you know?
Tanuki suit, yeah.
Yeah, like, why not the cat one, you know? Like, why not? Everybody has alternate...
Seven individual costumes would be a lot for 70-plus characters, but at least, like, two.
Yeah, not maybe. Yeah, not all. Character. But then, like, there are like you know, I like Donkey Kong with his white fur. Like, that's cool. Like, that's just a skin change. But that's like cool looking one. But then, like, yeah, like you, like Kirby could have some fun outfits.
Please
on
give
there.
Us Cat Bowser.
Kirby doesn't need any outfits. He can literally just suck up anybody.
That's true.
Kirby is the exception.
But yeah.
Oh my god.
Sadly, maybe only Kirby one character this year.
Crash.
That'd be terrifying. I think.
That would be adorable. With his little mohawk.
I could see like the little like. Pointy brown nose coming out of him.
That would be so adorable. I could see a Sonic rep come in. I could see a Tails or a Knuckles.
Really?
Maybe. Knuckles more than anything because he's a fighter. Nope, Big the Cat. Froggy.
Dude, yes.
Froggy.
We better see them in that Sonic movie.
I feel like at the end.
If we don't, or even like an end credit scene, like I just want to see what they look like.
Yeah.
A little tuft of like, you know how like Jim Carrey picks up the blue hair. So, like, at the end of the movie, he picks up, like, a yellow hair.
And that's it. I'd be like, fuck you, movie. Fuck you, Paramount, or whoever made this.
As he just, like, eats the hair.
Any more thoughts on Smash before we...
I mentioned before having Master Chief. It would be very nice to hear his voice in the game. Could we have a mode where we replace the narrator with Master Chief's voice?
That'd be cool.
Mario. Zelda. That's not even close to it, but growly voice.
It was just your voice, just a little bit deeper.
This summer. That's everyone's Master Chief impression.
Yeah.
Who's the voice actor?
No idea.
No.
No, I've never played a single Halo game. Only the online a little bit at my friend's house. But.
And while Waluigi is a joke, but it would be cool to see him in the game.
It would just be, it'd be nice. He'd be with his buddy and his arch nemesis, you know, just let them.
Have you guys ever seen the video? It's like an old Looney Tunes cartoon with just like this random dude. And he's like, it's a runabout. It's just a car. He's like, I'll steal it and nobody will ever know. Does that sound familiar?
No.
Someone painted Waluigi over that with the little envelope.
Oh.
It's like, I'll print it. Nobody will ever know.
You know, like the biggest troll is if like the next person announced or like the last final Smash character is announced and Waluigi's in the cutscene, but it's not him. That'd be evil as fuck.
That kind of in the vein of like the Banjo and the King K. Rool reveal where it's like the fake out.
Yeah. Because it was Duck Hunt, right?
Yeah, Duck Hunt was... Duck Hunt...
He said it.
...was Banjo, and then DDD was King K. Rool.
Yeah.
The Penguin was the Crocodile. Makes total sense. But I guess we can go over kind of like the whole backlash of Byleth. I think he and she look great. As far as like character design and play
style. Yeah, so the character that got announced, it's another anime sword character. Yeah. And
they even made the joke in the direct that was like, too many sword fighters? Huh, we'll give you more than a sword. It's like, that's funny.
And like, for me, I don't play as any of them. I don't really care.
Yeah.
Ike is fun. Ike is very fun.
I guess I felt upset for people who wanted something else. Mm. But like, as Caleb said, it is a very successful game and it gets the game out to a mm-hmm. broader mass. And the fact that it is switched between a guy and a girl, that is cool. So it mm-hmm. is technically like two characters.
The moveset is very distinct. He doesn't have a counter like every other Fire Emblem character does. I said before, character design looks way different because like Ike, Roy, Marth, Lucina all have like the same blue, gold, red color scheme. It's like, just give us Ike and Marth, and you can take Roy and Lucina back and give us something else. I want to exchange these two.
Although it's like probably like the, I wonder, there is probably some stats out there that like somebody could keep record of the character that has played the most and the least amount. Is there?
Oh yeah, yeah. There's, you can check that in the game.
Or everybody be like, oh wow, I have not touched that person. All.
Yeah. I understand Roy because that was pretty hype when he came out. Roy's our boy. Was a big.
When did he come out?
That was back in 4. He was one of the DLC characters. Mm. Made sense. He was in Melee. Everyone wanted him because his moveset was different enough from Marth. And he's a big competitive character. So there's a lot of history with him. I get it. And the trailer was fun because he attacked Roy. One of the Koopalings. And I was like, yeah, I get it. Mm. Roy. This is our Roy. I don't care. Krom is cool. I like Krom, even though he's like a clone of Ike. But everyone else is like a clone of Marth. Marth has two clones. That's kind of boring. Yeah.
Caleb really likes Smash.
A lot of people are equating this reveal to Corrin. None of you two have no idea who that is. No. He is the dragon boy that's in Final Smash. What the? In Super Smash. He's got like a platinum white color scheme. He's also boy girl. You can switch in between the two. He's got no shoes on. So there's a big foot fetish meme with him.
Very nice. Quentin Tarantino is all over that.
Right. But he was the last character to get announced for Smash 4. And so you can see the parallel of like, oh, Byleth is the last character for Smash Ultimate for this fighter pass.
But then you have the new pass coming out.
Right.
So so is it fair to say that the final character is always going to be an anime character?
Don't jinx it. Oh, Goku confirmed.
Not a bad one.
People would lose their freaking minds.
That'd be pretty crazy.
But I could see Nintendo could have handled it a little different because we got Joker was huge. Not a big fan, but I've never played Persona 5. The Hero was pretty big. Banjo blew up the internet. Terry, we're starting to go down. And then Byleth. So if you just like switched them in the middle and then put the big names at the end.
Yeah, if Banjo was the last one, you'd end out on a high note.
Yeah.
But
you could also argue that this is the middle section of the whole Fighter Pass.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because they announced six more characters. Mm-hmm. That is cool.
I'm excited. And Cuphead as a Mii Fighter costume.
Oh, and Assassin's Creed.
That's cool.
Altair.
They didn't even say he's from Assassin's Creed. They said he was from Altair.
Be like, okay, Assassin's Creed. Mm-hmm. But yeah, so that is Smash.
January 28th, everybody.
There you go.
Plays Byleth. Super cool. Can't wait to play.
So then, one more video game thing I want to talk about. What games are we excited for this year, guys? What are we going to get? What are we going to buy? What do we want to play?
Man, I haven't talked in a while.
Yeah. You fucking flat line, dude.
I don't really play a whole lot of Smash, so.
Yeah.
That was more just Caleb's time to shine. Do you want me to just go through my entire list?
No, we'll just go one at a time, because I assume definitely you and I are going to have some repeats, and you and Caleb might, because you both have a Switch, so.
So, the biggest one for me is probably going to be Doom Eternal.
Yeah.
Proud right there. Right.
Yeah. Playing Doom back in 2016, I think it came out. 2016?
15? Yeah.
Mid 2010s.
I bought it for Amazon Prime Day for like $20.
Ooh. I can't remember. I got mine pretty cheap too, I think. Anyways, it was just super fun, you know, just a completely revamped version of Doom genre.
Mm-hmm.
And, the blood and the gore and being able to rip and tear and
rip and tear.
Then with this one, like Doom Eternal, you get, you know, the same aspects, better guns, different, like, you know, areas to explore. I'm just super excited for it.
Yeah, go check out our reaction. It got a lot of love. So,
but it's also just
biceps.
Is this a face reveal? He actually had a face in the other game. You just did.
Like, no. I said in the in when we were discussion.
Do people just immediately pause it whenever you say something and they know the answer to it and they just type it in and then they go and they just stop watching the video? They're like, "I proved it wrong."
Oh my god, that guy was cool though. I responded to him.
A lot. The whole community was pretty great who commented on our reaction. So Doom Eternal, awesome. Caleb, what's one for you?
Animal Crossing,
and that's like coming out soon,
the same day as Doom Eternal.
Oh,
couldn't be two polar opposites.
Cute, loving animal community, death-defying demon slayer.
Oh my god, if we got Doom Guy in Smash.
and no matter what, like, what if they made a animation for every character of him just ripping off their, like, limbs or something?
That's a little too...
That'd be great.
Have you seen the Ridley reveal? That was pretty gruesome.
I haven't seen that one.
He murdered Mega Man and Mario.
Oh.
And then he twirled Mario's cap.
Oh.
In front of Samus. I haven't played Animal Crossing game. I do not look forward to how many hours I'm going to spend on it.
Girlfriend reviews loves it.
Mm-hmm.
That's going to be her
cute name. Characters. Cool islandy theme. I do love that there's like this cute little thing between Doom Guy and Isabel. Like, I've seen cute little comics about it. Just them. Have you guys seen the comic with like the German Shepherd and the little cat?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It was like the same vein of that.
Yeah. Okay.
With obviously Isabel as the German Shepherd.
For me, my biggest game this year is Last of Us Part Two.
Mm-hmm.
The first one is just, I didn't know a game could make me cry within the first like 15 minutes of it. And then the whole time the story was just amazing. I've probably played the story 3 to 4 times. I want to revisit it before I go and play this new one, but it looks beautiful. I don't really know anything much. They're keeping it a secret. I'm worried for Joel because it looks like we're going to be playing as Ellie a lot of the game, but hopefully we do get to take control of Joel a little bit. But hopefully he's in it, so that's a game I'm really excited for.
I guess we can just keep going down this way.
So, Matt, go ahead.
Next one. It's going to be for the Switch.
It's
Pokemon Mystery Dungeon DX.
Yeah.
Heard you talking about that.
Yeah, I just growing up, playing on the DS, I loved Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Blue. Just the top-down dungeon scroller, go floor by floor, battling legendaries and, you know, potentially going back to fight them again, and then you can actually have them join you and your party.
Such a fun concept.
Yeah, it was really... It was just such a fun game because, you know, you kind of just wake up one day as a Pokemon and you kind of just go throughout this entire story trying to figure out what happened, and you know, you're trying to figure out if, you know, you hear the story about a human who grabbed the nine tails by the tails and you're like, fuck, was that me? Was that somebody else? And it's just it was a really great game, and I'm really looking forward to this one with the revamped art style, different combat style or different combat layouts. It looks like it's gonna be a lot of fun.
Do you think it's going to get more praise than the most recent Sword and Shield games?
I mean, it's still a spinoff, but I think everyone
is like...
I don't think there's anyone that's mad about the
look
choice
of it, or yeah.
Right, that's
or
cool.
Just the fact that they're doing it.
Yeah,
because I really want this game to do successful, so they keep making more of them. Because I think there's only like 4 games. There's the first two that's combining into one for this one.
Yeah,
definitely a third one. I think they stopped at 4, maybe 5.
I don't know, I only played the first one.
Mm-hmm. But it's gonna be refreshing, and like you said, the art style looks really cool.
Mm-hmm.
Can't wait. I have the demo. I need to play it. You're against it because you just want to get into it.
What is your next game?
It's not confirmed, but heavy rumors of a Metroid Prime trilogy remaster.
Ooh.
It makes perfect sense.
Ooh.
Drop it before 4, and 4 is delayed, so that gives you plenty of time. Retro could have been working on that before taking over for 4. And, dude, just come on. I want it.
I think it's, a lot of people would want
so
it.
So good, yeah. Because the fourth one for the next gen, it's like, I haven't played the first 3. Here you go. Play the first 3. Yeah, can't wait.
Yeah.
Do it.
Kind of a random one here that I have is, it's a smaller game, but Dark Crystal Age of Resistance Tactics. It's just awesome.
What? I just fucking knew it was going to be a Muppet thing.
Well, that's because, like, there aren't that many games out like that. And so the fact that the show for Netflix is getting their own little tactic game, and it's totally not my kind of game, but I'm going to give it a shot. And it comes out.
You'll probably like it.
Yeah, it comes out, like, in April. So I'm really excited for it. And I was, because I remember at first it was announced just for the Switch, and I was fucking pissed. And I was like, okay, Caleb, I'm probably going to buy it and then play it on your Switch. But now it's for PlayStation, so. Yeah, just a small little game that I'm excited for. So,
yeah, I don't think it really would have really helped anyone by making it permanently exclusive.
Yeah, and like, yeah, it's kind of kiddish graphics, so yeah, it can go on anything. It doesn't have to be like the best graphics ever, but
it's just so weird that it's a Netflix-led thing, and yet Switch still doesn't have Netflix. It's got Hulu and YouTube. Can we get Netflix, please?
My next most anticipated game. Rainbow Six Quarantine.
Okay.
We don't really know anything about it. We kind of got a small, like, 30-second, 45-second trailer of some guy getting chased by creatures or something. And he had some kind of, like, weird armband, wristband.
Rainbow Six.
And there was, like, a weird disease crawling up his arm or something. I don't know. The whole game is shrouded in mystery. And at the end, we saw two very famous operators. I think we saw Thermite and Ella come in. And like, I've been playing Rainbow Six a lot. It's definitely a fun game, and the fact that they, you know, have been showing it, Ubisoft been like supporting it for 3-4 years now. It's just, it kind of shows you just how dedicated they are to the series, and I'm really looking forward to this next entry.
Hmm. How long have you been playing Rainbow Six?
Quite a while, probably at least 2 years.
Okay. I remember, like, Rainbow Six 2 was, like, my first, like, really fun online experience before any Call of Duty game. It was Rainbow Six 2.
Tom Clancy, right? That dude has too many games.
He's got too many books.
He's just everywhere.
He's
becoming immortal.
One of his books finally become a movie? Is that what...
There's plenty of them.
Hunt for Red October.
Oh, dang.
Jack Reacher.
Jack Ryan.
That's what I'm thinking of with John Krasinski.
Yeah. Well, that's a show, but then there was the movie. Jack Ryan was Chris Pine. Maybe both of them.
Oh, yeah.
Because Chris Pine played him, and it was a really boring movie. I remember that.
Maybe Tom Cruise was Jack Reacher, but then...
He was Jack Reacher, and then it became a show.
Yeah, for Amazon Prime, that's right.
So there's a lot out there.
Yeah, I mean, he's basically the Stephen King of war.
Yeah.
Someone would argue that's too much.
Damn, yeah. Can we get a Stephen King game? That'd be cool.
What would it be?
Maybe like The Dark Tower, and then you can go to all the different stories.
Yeah, The Dark Tower makes sense.
There's quite a big series.
Did anybody see that?
Nope.
That movie?
I think it's supposed to be a show now, if I'm not mistaken. They're trying to make a show out of it.
Okay.
I don't know, but.
Probably should have started there.
You got one?
More rumors. We don't have a December game yet. So that could be Breath of the Wild 2.
That's bold.
Make it happen. Or Odyssey 2. We haven't seen anything on that yet. But those are two games
that
really...
Are ever going to make another Mario Galaxy? Or is Odyssey now the next Mario
Maybe
thing?
Not yet. Because like there is 64, then Sunshine, then Galaxy, and now Odyssey.
Dude, so Galaxy Mario Galaxy was so much fun.
Right? You could cap it off with a 3, a trilogy, remaster the first 2.
Or Mario Sunshine 2.
Yeah. I would take a remaster of that as well.
Yeah, that'd be a good one to
remaster. That's probably my favorite Mario game.
Oh, dude.
I mean, it's like, it's up there.
Yeah.
It's
really good. If Galaxy didn't have as much diversity, Sunshine would take it for me.
Nope. Sunshine, all the way.
Mm-hmm. Have you played Galaxy 2?
Not Galaxy 2.
It. Bro, you'd think sequelitis, it's so fun.
No, I'm sticking strong with Sunshine.
I don't know how you would
nostalgia that it gives me.
Remaster the first 2. I guess you could take the pointer controls out of it because you can still shake.
I'll tell you how to do it. you don't. You just remaster Sunshine.
We did get that pic with Mario's toes. Ooh. Eating watermelon. You know what I'm talking about?
He has like nipples or something too now, doesn't he?
Yeah, because
his nipples are exposed in Odyssey.
Yeah.
That's right. Gross.
Brief nudity. Mild nudity.
Super Mario Sunshine doesn't have that.
But it needs it.
It has Mario with short sleeves, and that's what we needed at the time.
We need the elbows.
Mario's like, yeah. Fuck this shit.
Isn't that like Mickey Mouse? I got some games that hopefully we get news of them at E3. Dying Light 2.
I would if like Sony would decide to show sure up that's finally.
Been confirmed.
I
oh, well, you're just talking about like news though.
Either release this year or next year, just like an official date.
This year.
Lego Star Wars: The Complete Skywalker Saga. I would like a release date for that. SpongeBob Battle for Bikini Bottom Remaster. Ooh. I would like a release date for that. And my boy right here, my Nord, Elder Scrolls. Okay, I need
not
something.
Sponsored by NordVPN.
I've been on a Skyrim fix right now, and
he does.
I need my next one. So give me a release date, please.
This would be 7. Skyrim 6?
6.
Okay, sorry.
So, and that the trailer when they announced it, it would be 2 years. So it was announced in 2018. So hopefully they
kind of has a habit of game developers coming out and just being like November, like Fallout 4. Todd Howard came out and he's like,
Tom Holland,
what's up?
But then
Skyrim, just kidding. Fallout 4.
And then it was awful.
No, Fallout 4 was
no awesome. Fallout 76 yes. Though when that was announced and yeah. Then that came out like 2 months later and everybody fucking hated it.
Yeah.
So
what happened?
We don't talk about it.
Quick question for you guys.
Mm-hmm.
What is one game that you're hoping for to get an announcement by the end of this year? Not to get released this year.
Like new game?
What's one game that you're hoping for? That's not on like, it's not been confirmed or anything yet.
Right.
Do you have one in mind?
I just want to get some news that God of War 2 is in development. Even if it's just like, hey, we wrote the first sentence. I'm like, yes! Yes!
The...
That's it.
All right. That's I guess on the latter half of that, Spider-Man 2.
Yeah.
I'd like Spider-Man 2. I would like to know another reason why I have Kingdom Hearts up here is because the DLC drops tomorrow after this podcast. So hopefully maybe at E3 we get just an announcement of what the next game title is going to be, or when they're shooting for the next game, if it's going to be a big number or is it going to be like a spinoff. So Spider-Man and the future of Kingdom Hearts for me. So do you have one?
I guess I'll stick with the sequel theme and go Odyssey 2.
Odyssey 2.
Because Breath of the Wild
was announced. Yeah, it was confirmed. Mm-hmm. So
that doesn't count.
Do you think they will do an Odyssey 2? Was Odyssey successful?
Super successful.
All right. Fair enough. Okay.
It's a 3D Mario platformer.
Yeah, everybody loves Mario.
If we haven't gotten the DLC by now, then
was it rumored for DLC?
Yeah, when the foot pic came out of him eating watermelon, it was like, oh, we're getting DLC because there's heavy rumor that we're getting like a Sunshine Island or like island because it's on a globe because there was originally a dolphin shaped island before and they took it out, so it's like Nintendo, mm-hmm. What are you doing? You're weird behind the door stuff. And no, we didn't get anything. So that was either a Sunshine thing, an Odyssey 2 thing, or...
Shits and giggles,
because it was the summer.
Yeah. Wow. So, yeah, almost like a full... It's been like 6 months. Mm-hmm. So,
somebody would say exactly 6 months.
Any other games that you had, or just God of War, really?
definitely
kind of sucks that... Sorry. That Sony's not going to be at E3, so... Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but it's also just like... Because it seems like they're going more on their own route of doing like these... directs like Nintendo does where they just kind of do state of plays.
It's nice.
If that's the case, okay. But it doesn't seem like it's as big of an
event.
Yeah, as the Nintendo directs are. Like,
because that's like their own thing. They established that.
Yeah.
And then E3 was like for the Xbox and PlayStation and it's like an event. It's only once a year, like let's go.
And then like
Sony likes to do a lot of things that Nintendo has already done. Motion control. Directs.
Well, it's called State of Play. But, like, the thing is, it's just, like, I'll be scrolling through, like, Facebook. And that's how I saw the Doom trailer was released. I'm like, oh, fuck. They released a couple, like, you know, articles and news and stuff. So I was just like, let's do a reaction.
And we did. And it was like 2 days late, but we still got views.
Biceps.
So.
Yeah. Well, that's going to wrap it up for video games.
Speaking of Sony, I don't know if you have this in there. How much news do you have? There are heavy rumors that Apple is in works to buy Sony.
Dear God, no.
But.
I like Sony being its own thing.
But.
Can companies stop fucking buying each other? This is literally monopoly in real life now.
I told Matt this already. If Sony is bought by someone, that means Disney, by default, gets the rights to Spider-Man back.
That's right. And I was just actually like, fuck, okay, I'm actually kind of down with that.
For free. So that is why Disney has.
But if they buy Sony in a whole.
I don't know, it's kind
of no, idea. Because what Caleb's
over Spider-Man though. I don't know.
Like for the greater good, what's happening? Apple gets Sony, but we get Spider-Man back.
But it's just like what can like can Apple really fuck up Sony as much as Disney fucked up everything else?
I don't know, dude.
That shouldn't be the perspective. I feel like we're Apple's going.
Just like. I just feel like I don't know, like Apple, like yes, like I have iPhone.
They're making a car.
I have the laptop. I have AirPods. Like yes, like I am in the Apple community, but like. A thing about Apple is that they always crunch out things every year or two.
Barely any innovation.
Yeah, they have the new AirPods that nobody gives a fuck about. And so my worry
AirPod Pros.
That like.
Because they're expensive.
Is that like, I don't know, they could do something with the PlayStation. And
I don't think they will.
I don't know. And if they make it fucking white, if they make it look like an Apple product.
I think they're only buying Sony studios. I don't think they're buying Sony outright.
Okay, so like they're still in control of like their cameras and
their cameras and their games.
Their games.
But I'm not totally sure. I could be wrong. It could be Sony outright. It could just be Sony studio, their film studio.
Well, this is news to me. So fuck that.
But Spider-Man for free. What did it cost?
So the SAGs came out 2 days ago.
Saggy titties?
Yes. The Screen Actor Guild Award, and it's pretty much whoever wins this wins the Oscar. So, also, I did not know they had a stunt category, which is cool. It's I think the Oscars should have that as well.
Yeah, weren't we talking about that for best stunt?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Doesn't Tom Cruise just win that every year?
Not this year. Endgame won best stunts, so that is cool. And for TV shows, Game of Thrones, so... That was pretty cool. Supporting actor, supporting actor and actress, Laura Dern and Brad Pitt. So it's pretty much guaranteed they've been winning all of them.
Yeah.
Weren't those our picks for the Oscars?
Yes. Renina Zellweger won Best Actress. Nobody gives a shit, but she's gonna win it just because it's her time, I guess. And Joaquin Phoenix won Best Actor at the SAG. So, ladies and gentlemen. I think he's going to win the Oscar.
It's kind of a sad day.
I did enjoy his speech. It was funny and humble because he jokes with Leo because they kind of were both popular. Like they were the same age at the same time, like getting popular. He calls out Christian Bale. He's like, can you for once just suck in a movie, please? Your performances are always great. He said he loved
how the camera pans to a malnourished Christian Bale. He's like, no.
He said he loved watching Adam Driver expand as an actor the last few years, and he knows he's gonna go places.
Well, that's kind of nice.
He said, good job, Taren. That's all he said, pretty much.
Cause whatever.
Taren's a new actor.
Adam's new too. Like he has years.
Yeah.
To get his award.
And then at the very end, though, he thanks Heath Ledger, which was pretty sweet. It was a very sweet speech. Brad Pitt's was pretty fucking hilarious. He was like, I want to thank Margot Robbie's feet, Dakota Fanning's feet, and Quentin Tarantino for making all these actresses show their feet. And it was hilarious. All the big buzz. Jennifer Aniston won Best Actress for her show Good Morning or Good Day or whatever it's called, the Apple TV show.
I think it's Good Day.
And there's like a picture of like them like hugging and they're like, oh my gosh. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I don't care. But why I have this man right here, the sexy devil for Goodfellas. Robert De Niro won the Lifetime Achievement Award.
Huh.
And I just love De Niro, dude.
Can we call it something else? Because the first thing I think of is a Lifetime channel.
Yeah, you know, you got Goodfellas, you got Taxi Driver, you got The Godfather, you got
The Irishman,
obviously. Meet the Fockers. It's just a slate of movies. I don't talk about Raging Bull because that movie was really boring. But Did you fuck my wife? But yeah, cool. And he was in Joker. He's really good in that too. So Robert De Niro won. But the surprise of the night, ladies and gents,
Cats won Best Picture.
The first foreign film to ever win Best Ensemble Cast, which is pretty much Best Picture, at the SAGs. Parasite.
Yes.
Parasite won, and it was pretty awesome. All the actors got up there, and they were very humble and sweet. And
Oh, yeah, that's the picture I saw. They did look so sweet.
Yeah, so it's really cool that Parasite won Best Ensemble. So it's the first foreign film to win. So it's kind of like, is it going to be a thing where, like, Sam Mendes wins Best Director, Parasite wins Best Picture, or vice versa, 1917 Best Picture, and Bong wins Best Director? Who knows?
I think the first option.
Yeah. I think Parasite deserves Best Picture while Sam Mendes deserves Best Director.
Yeah. That's how I think it's going to go. And I kind of like that. I don't really like, unless it's like a ridiculously, like, if there's like no other movie that should win, like, take the best two movies, give the best director the one, and then give the other director the best picture.
Because, like, yeah. I want both of these movies to win, but it's just like, that's the thing that sucks about awards. It's like, you can't have two winners. Like, it's just.
Yeah. I know, it's hard. So, but that was really cool that he won that. And then I got just some box office domestic stuff from January 17th to the 19th last weekend. Bad Boys came out on top.
Sweet.
With $62.2 million.
Oh, life.
Its budget is $90 million, so it's definitely going to make it back. 1917 came in second with $22 million. Also a budget of $19 million.
This was
$90 million.
Second week?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
First week it made almost $40 million. So.
Okay.
Yeah, because it dethroned Star Wars, because Star Wars is dead now. And shockingly, Dulu also made $22 million in the box office, but its budget is the last two movies combined, pretty much, at $175 million dollar budget.
I feel like that might have been just like a little throwaway movie just to keep the rights. Do you think?
No, at $175 million
to keep the rights to a fucking Doolittle.
If it was
this
a throwaway
is the third
movie,
time Doolittle's been remade.
If
so.
It was a throwaway movie, time? Yeah. Eddie Murphy was the second time.
Yeah, there's an original like in the 60s.
Oh.
And then Eddie Murphy like came back. And,
well,
like,
fuck, he was good at it.
Yeah. And then, yeah, this is like a serious take based on true events.
If they're trying to do a serious movie, they would have done like stock footage of animals and just do the thing where...
I would just watch Planet Earth. And then have some British dude talk to them.
It would be like $10 million.
Dude, no. It would be what... you didn't know about this. David Lynch's birthday was yesterday. The man, I think, turned 75. And Netflix, out of fucking nowhere, just drops it without an announcement. It was called What Did Jack Do? And it's a 17-minute short of David Lynch interrogating a monkey. I would go pay $10 to see that instead of $10 to see Doolittle. Because that just sounds like a lot more fun. And it's David Lynch, so you know
does
it's going to kind of be weird.
Does the monkey talk
back? I have no idea.
Why do you like bananas?
But
it's the scene from Ad Astra.
I was shocked Doolittle made that much money. I don't think it's going to make that much money this weekend, though. But it made some money. I was hoping it was going to make
If anything, the people that wanted to see a bad movie got out of the way. And they're just like, okay.
Yeah.
It's better than Cats.
Mitchell saw it.
Of course he did.
Don't ask me why.
Why?
His girlfriend. Supposedly. Yeah. Anyways. Moving on to some movie and TV news, guys. Mulan. There is confirmed no Mushu and no singing. But the original music will be honored.
Okay.
Right.
So
it's going to be
like,
in the score.
Yeah.
There's no way it's not going to be.
Yeah. And I mean, you kind of get a taste of it in the trailer.
Mm-hmm.
But now we're confirmed by Disney that I don't know why there's not even a little nod to Mushu. I wish that was a thing. But I guess I would say they're going for a more realistic approach. But then you have like this witch villain.
Yeah.
Well, like, I mean, that's still like lore.
It's lore.
Chinese lore.
But like, come on, Mushu.
Mythology.
Just have like a little red dragon somewhere.
Well, that's what the Phoenix is. The Phoenix. Is Mushu.
But little red
and
dragon.
Then Disney turned the Phoenix into Mushu.
Little red dragon.
Apparently the cricket
still think
is in it.
We should just have a CGI Eddie Murphy, just a little costume, just like, you know, really short. Just... running around
just like that. But yeah,
and so, make him red. That could be our version of Will Smith in this movie.
So just that, they confirm no singing. Thank God.
Man, I'd be okay with like a few songs.
But like,
I can already.
I don't want it to be a musical, but like, you know, one at the beginning, one at the end.
It's just
maybe in the middle.
Did you guys see Jungle Book?
Nah.
Yes.
Yes. And did any of you guys? We all saw Lion King. Did you any of you see Beauty and the Beast?
No.
No. So like, Beauty and the Beast and the Lion King had songs throughout.
Right.
The Jungle Book, randomly, the bears, like the Bear Necessity or whatever it's called. That was more of like just like a little like tune in it. But then when Christopher Walken shows up and it's the I Want to Be You or whatever.
I Want to Be Just Like You.
Yeah, yeah, that. It felt so out of place because the whole movie was just this movie. And then this full out musical number with dancing monkeys and Christopher Walken singing. And you're just like, the rest of the movie, like The Bear's Necessity, it was just kind of like a song. And, you know, movies sometimes have songs in them. But this was like a musical number. And so if that happens in here, if there's like a Fallout musical number.
I don't see it happening.
But I could see like a character singing a song.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I would be okay with that.
Yeah.
Kind of like 1917.
Like but I don't want like, you know, choreography, dance.
No. Because like Lion King and Beauty and the Beast are musicals. Not in the sense of Les Miserables where they sing the entire time. Mm-hmm. But like they all break out into dance numbers and stuff like that. But yeah, like if Mulan, like if it's like her just singing a song alone, or like, yeah, like if it's just a person singing a song, I'm fine with that. Mm-hmm. But apparently there's no singing, so
I can already hear I'll Make a Man Out of You on like a cello or something, like a bassy instrument during the training sequence.
This is pretty cool. So HBO Max is making a animated Aquaman series. It's gonna be 3 parts, produced by James Wan, and it's gonna be focusing in on Arthur as his first days of king in Atlantis. So this is going to be lore to the Aquaman.
Great filler content.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So because this would be cool to watch, and then this leads up to
Aquaman 2.
Aquaman 2.
That's
they could do a Star Wars, the Clone Wars kind of thing with seasons 1 and 2 leading up to episode 3.
Yeah, and I think it's like
Squirrels.
I think it's a really cool approach because also DC animated is where it's at when it comes to Marvel or DC. DC does it better. So I can already, and also it's produced by James Wan, so it's cool that he has a hand in the story. So he's
after the CW, no more TV shows. Animated is what you're good at. Marvel has their filler content. DC's got their filler content.
Marvel has really good live action shows for the most part. Not their TV stuff, but like, you know,
what we're going to see
Inhumans or whatever.
I got hope.
That was like Inhumans, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I don't think is too bad, but it's just like when it gets down to like the cheesy animation, you're just like, nah.
It's lazy, kind of.
Yeah, because like The Flash, you like you watched it and you're like, it's kind of dumb. But they did have, what's The Flash's name from the Justice League?
Oh, Ezra Miller. Yeah, yes. That whole that connection was pretty cool.
He was in the
like, the fact that they pulled that off without any like leak footage.
Yeah.
No, I mean like, that was pretty cool.
Yeah.
But it's also just like,
I think it's because it's a TV show and they're like, nobody cares.
Right? No, but nobody cares.
Because David was the only one who was like, I know you guys don't care, but look! And I'm just like,
I don't care, but I thought it was cool.
No, yeah,
to show that like Ezra Miller is still committed to the role of the Flash. To
it still looked like crap.
Yeah, it looked really weird. Like his fade in, fade out. I didn't really watch the scene. I just saw the picture. But
yeah. But yeah, super cool.
But that's really cool. It's going to be 3 parts. Don't know how. Is it 3 parts? I don't know if that's like
How long are episodes?
Or like 3 seasons or like,
whoa.
I have no idea. But like how long, like 3 parts, like is it going to be like,
dude, like 3 hour long?
Yeah. Episodes, like, that'd be pretty cool. And you release maybe once a month or something. Mm-hmm. But yeah, so that's happening. I don't know when. I don't think there was a release date that I could look. But yeah, so that's cool. DC, if that's what you're going to do to filler up these movies, go for it. Also, some new, not like DC news, but Taika Waititi is being eyed by Lucasfilm to make a Star Wars one. And it gets me excited, but worried at the same time.
Right.
Because the dude already has a lot on his plate. And if this is anything, it's going to remind me of what I think we all came to the conclusion of what happened at D&D when they got announced, when they were told they were going to make a Star Wars trilogy. They said, okay, fuck this project we're working on. Let's focus on Star Wars. If that is really the case, I hope Tyke is not like that, and I hope he's like, cool Lucasfilm, but I want to make Akira and Thor first,
yeah,
and then I'll come to you.
Yeah, like, Taika has a lot more integrity.
Yeah.
He loves Akira.
I feel like he also will just be a lot more, I don't know the good way to put this, like narrative driven. Like he
cares about story.
Yeah, well, I don't know. I feel like he's smart. He's not going to let it distract him. He's going to focus on Thor, and then he's going to move on to Akira, and then he's like, okay, now I can give Star Wars my full attention, mm-hmm. if that's what you guys still want. So I feel like, I don't know. I mean, he's a great director, but it's like you said, he's got a lot of stuff on his plate, so it's just like, yeah, just chill.
What do you think he will aim for Star Wars? What do you think that they want him to do? What kind of...
IG. A whole movie about him.
I've been hearing a lot of people talking about how they really want an Old Republic movie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And if what Star Wars is doing right now with bringing Kevin Feige on, Taika Waititi, is J.J. Abrams coming back?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
Please, no.
There was somebody else that was big that was being moved around.
Well, Rian Johnson's still in talks for his trilogy. Mm-hmm. Jon Favreau obviously has The Mandalorian. Shit, you have the one female director doing an Obi-Wan show. I don't remember her name, but...
But either way, I feel like the Old Republic could be a very big possibility with either Taika or Rian Johnson. And then, you know, maybe even have Taika and Rian working on that trilogy together and then having Kevin Feige, you know...
Is Kevin Feige doing one movie or a trilogy like that?
I don't know. The whole news around that is very... I can't fucking think.
That's okay. I mean, this is just very loose base news, yeah. But make Akira first and make Thor, yeah. Obviously.
Mm-hmm.
Also, some awesome news why it's up here over on Matt's side. National Treasure 3 is officially announced.
I've heard about it. Bro, the fucking Quran.
The Quran.
Like I said.
And it is going to be written by the dude who wrote Bad Boys for Life. So
okay, I'd be fine with that.
Just then. A fun action Nicolas Cage movie.
Dude, I'm okay the National that. Treasure movies are just...
They're a national treasure.
Honestly, yes. they're just amazing. They're underrated. Well, I mean, like, you know, they're well known, but it's mm-hmm. just like, you know, you kind of think about it and you're like, yeah, those were good movies. I'd like to go back to them.
Yeah.
Cinemassacre just did... It was National Treasure versus something else, and James, like, the nerd, he said National Treasure is hand down his favorite Nicolas Cage movie. And I'm like, you know what? Respect.
It is.
It's a really good movie.
I think Con Air might be my favorite Nick Cage movie.
I think it was definitely the first one. That was probably my first introduction to Nicolas Cage.
Yeah.
Was National Treasure. And I remember like watching it and loving the fuck out of it. Mm-hmm. You got the dude from The Hangover in it. You got Sean Bean.
That's where he is now.
Who's the old guy who plays his dad?
Oh, my gosh.
Because I know he's fucking familiar. I just can't think of his goddamn name. Gene Wilder. No.
Gene Hackman?
No. Just look it up. Oh, my gosh. That's going to bug me. From the dude from Holes, right?
He was in Speed. Was he? No. That was Hannibal, right? The bad guy in Speed?
Oh. Oh, like with Keanu Reeves?
Yeah.
It says Christopher Plummer, but I don't
know.
No, it's not Christopher Plummer.
No.
Are y'all looking this
up? I didn't know who Speed is.
I'm just going to awkwardly...
Anthony Hopkins, I think, is the bad guy
in
Speed.
John Voight.
Let me see a picture.
Yeah, that's him.
That's, okay, yo, he's from Holes, right? That's the guy from Holes.
So then wait.
Because that's Angelina Jolie's dad, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, no, it was Dennis Hopper. God, we are all over the place.
Okay, so Christopher Plummer was in National Treasure.
What? Who does he play?
Who does Nick Cage play in...
What is happening?
I don't know. Gene Hackman was the guy, and he's from Replacements and The French Connection, Enemy of the State.
Movies, guys.
We know our old white actors.
We need Akshay here. Akshay would just be like, oh, yes, he was in this, that. His birthday is this.
Wait, this is a social security number?
Okay, bet.
National Treasure.
National Treasure 3.
We get our trilogy.
And it's not confirmed if it's going to be like a Disney Plus or if it's going to be a...
Put a budget into
theatrical release. But yes, and Nicolas Cage. Woo! Ooh, here we go. Your girl.
ATJ?
No.
Haley Steinfeld?
No.
JTA?
No, the other one.
You put me on the spot. I don't like it. Give me a hint.
Marvel Universe. That's easy.
Oh, Florence Pugh?
No.
What?
What the Florence?
Who?
Nebula.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Scarlett Johansson.
Red hair. Just say red hair.
Red hair. Fair enough. She really wants to play Batgirl.
Yeah, I can see it. Or
she wants to direct it if she doesn't get it. Mm-hmm. So that'd be cool to see her direct it.
Yeah.
Get some girl power there.
Just look at it. I could have done a much better fucking job than you, you piece of shit.
Well, you look at the freaking show and you're like, oh my God.
Well, no, I know, but I'm just
throwing acid in your eyes.
Like, if she doesn't get to play as Batgirl.
Apparently it's good. I don't know. Ask David.
As David. At David Jones.
At Jones Design.
No, it's not that anymore. Fuck. What is it?
Art by Art of David Jones?
No. We're not going to shout him out if he doesn't even listen to our podcast.
That's true. He's like halfway through Captain Marvel.
Okay, but to be fair, he did make the shit for the new podcast.
And I shouted him out, and that's it.
Yeah.
So
that's it. That's all he gets.
Okay.
But that's cool. So
careful, because he might just, you know, ask us to pay him. Jackass.
Takes.
Love you, David.
But that was, I think it was just kind of like a conversation. I don't think anything's in the works. I remember when freaking Josh Whedon was attached to it. He really wanted to make a Batgirl movie.
That's the thing I hate about media today. It's just like, just, you know, some random person just like, hey, what do you want to do next? Oh, well, I would love to do a Red Hood movie. Red Hood confirmed 2022. This guy's doing it. It's like, no, I just said I would like to.
50 videos get made about confirm.
So this is why I believe Red Hood is actually Jason Bateman. I don't know. I'm just fucking around.
Jason Bateman, Jason Todd, confirmed. Did you do that on purpose?
I don't know. I was just
Jason Bateman's a little too old for Jason Todd.
I just threw names out.
The most recent name we were thinking of.
Yeah.
I love you, Jason
Bateman. Also, I love Karen Gillan. But she's like 30, so like she's the only one that's like not realistic as far as like making it big.
Get the girl from Kim Possible.
Yes. A true, no. Karen Gillan make a true Kim Possible movie.
She might be of age.
Jesus Christ.
FBI, open up!
This is
squirrels!
This is really cool. So Quentin Tarantino ended up writing 5 half-hour episodes of Bounty Law.
Jesus.
And he said he wants to direct him. So could we get them and like put them on Netflix or something, have a Leo return and just have some like big name actors play the villains in each episode? You know how cool that would be?
Oh, Bounty Law is the
fictional show from Once Upon a Time.
That'd be fucking
dope. He ended up writing just 5 episodes. Just,
of course he did.
Yeah, because he can just fucking write. So yeah, like what if you could just get some like big actors in there to play like the one-offs like he was in the actual Once Upon a Time.
We only have one more movie from him, right?
Yeah.
But apparently, I'm retired.
It's apparently going to be like something huge. Remember I told, like, I had like that little paragraph he said talking about like foreshadowing like all of his past movies. It's going to be like one big hurrah.
What if this is Tarantino's like loophole? It's like he wants to do TV. So he'll be done with movies after this movie, and then he just does TV.
I'm cool with that.
Almost the Mandalorian, make hour-long episodes and make them super bloody.
Oh, yes.
Oh, my God.
But that's cool. Bounty Law, I hope it's like also in black and white. That'd be really fun. Just make it feel super old, but it's like, that's Leo. Like, it'd be cool. I mean, get Leo back.
Was it black and white, though? I thought it was like just that Specta Vision look.
I have no idea.
Yeah, I don't think it was. Like, it had some, like, make it look like MASH.
Yeah,
like that kind of color.
Retro, yeah. Just make it look old. Don't make
really
it look new.
And television, like, that's, you know, now that Leo has his Oscar, like he did really fucking good in Once Upon a Time. So maybe hopefully he'll just be like, yeah, fuck it, I'll go back to this TV show and work with you, Quentin.
And also it's Quentin, you know, like
he's like, probably he's gonna take good care of him.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah,
let me see your feet. Unless you're, what's her name, Kill Bill.
Oh, Uma Thurman.
Yeah.
Oh my God, her fucking daughter is so goddamn hot.
Oh my God.
This is some sad news. I think I told you guys.
Maya Hawk is engaged.
Disney officially got rid of the Fox name.
That's lame.
So 20th Century Fox is now going to be called 20th Century Studios. And Fox Searchlight is now just going to be called Searchlight Studios.
Dude, you're getting rid of history.
So Fox is gone.
Was there some like beef back in the day when Disney and Fox and like the golden era and Disney's now just like, our revenge has come full circle.
There's going to be movies later on. When
Bob Iger just goes into like the basement of fucking the castle at Disney
World. Oh my God.
He's just like, what should we do now, Master? Well, Disney just turns like around Darth on a block Sidious. Of ice. He's like, kill Fox.
He looks like Darth Sidious from episode 9.
Yeah.
With his fingers all decrepit like that.
Oh my gosh. But for real, it's really sad. The next time we see it's going to say 20th Century Studios.
I want to point at my kids and be like, that used to be a studio.
It used to be called Fox. 20th Century Fox. What and it, now it is.
It's got to keep the music.
Is it going to be called 21st Century?
Because we're in the 21st century. Oh my
God. I have no idea. It's a new studio, so could they?
We've been in the 21st century.
But I'm saying, like, now that it's a new studio, could they just call it 21st Century Studios? Because it's, like, technically not Fox anymore.
Right.
If you're getting rid of it entirely, just fucking do it.
What if Fox just took the money that they got from Disney and was just like, we're going to make our own studio. 21st Century Fox Studios opens up.
Boom! But
where does that money go?
Laying people off. Taxes.
Well, no, it's not going anywhere. The studio is still there.
I have no idea.
Like, does the owner of Fox get all the money? He's like, nah, I'm retired.
Well, he's probably just... He probably got fucking born there just like, there he is. That's the new fucking CEO of Fox. 3-day-old baby. Nah, I'm retired.
I love that this is going to be a meme.
I got two more here. Better Call Saul is renewed for a 6th season. The 5th season's coming out. Is
it going that long?
It's the final season.
Jesus Christ.
6th and final season.
Breaking Bad had 5?
6.
I got to get caught up on that show.
Yeah, I haven't seen season 4 because it's not on fucking Netflix yet. And we don't have Caleb. We don't have Cable, so we can't even watch the new season. I hate Cable.
Bro, I know how we could get Cable. Get Cyclops.
Get
Scarlet Witch. Get him a fucking bang. 30 years in the future, he comes back to us. He's like, Father, I have returned. And I'm like, give me some Cable.
But yeah, I'm just really excited. And it looks like Hank's returning for the final season. Looks like they're going to be sprinkling in some characters. So he's returning.
Yeah, because they had Gus in the 5th season.
5
right?
seasons, you butt munch.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah. Well. Better Call Saul is amazing, so I'm cool that there's another season. But yeah, they're going to be sprinkling in some characters. So maybe some Walter White. He was great in the one scene he was in El Camino.
What if they did like a Lord of the Rings, The Hobbit thing, where the last episode of Saul is where Walter White walks into his office?
Ooh. I hope so. Like the last like few episodes do that.
Yeah, Rogue One.
In, just add some new scenes. Because that's pretty much what El Camino was. It just...
I still have to watch that.
Was
yeah.
scenes of episodes that we just didn't watch.
Why wasn't El Camino bigger than what it was?
Netflix movie, maybe?
Yeah.
But like Marriage Story.
The scene with Walter White took place in season 2. So
I think we should go back, rewatch Breaking Bad, watch El Camino, and then start Better Call Saul.
I want to revisit Better Call Saul. Just like watch it entirely because it's a good show. I love lawyer talk. And lastly, Watchmen season 2 is unlikely going to happen because Damon stepped off.
Yeah.
So
I thought that was pretty much already.
It's confirmed. Like there were rumors like how like the show got praised. You know, HBO probably wanted to do a second season.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
He was like, nah.
It's probably a good thing though, because like you know, it kind of left off at a really good moment where is she Dr. Manhattan? Is she not?
Forgot to ask that question to Akshay if he thinks she's Dr. Manhattan now.
Yeah, I assume she is. Because it was the egg.
Schrodinger's Manhattan.
That was nice. That was a nice
thank
play.
You. Thank you.
But yeah, so just, I'm glad that it's going to be kind of his one-off thing. It's really cool.
That script was too good to just make another season out of. It was
You could have made like
perfect and well-rounded for that.
One more episode and throw Night Owl in there? That's about it.
Give us the owl.
That's about it. So.
Did you guys like the thumbnail for the Watchmen reaction review?
That was a good one.
Did you see how I made you?
Oh, Osmanius?
Yes.
Yes, that's right. And you're Night Owl and our mystery guest.
Oh, I'm actually in there?
No.
Oh.
I said he was.
Oh, well, you're looking at me. So.
Oh, sorry. No. You're in the thumbnail for anticipated movies, even though you weren't in it.
Does Matt appreciate my work?
Yeah, I always do.
That's funny. I couldn't leave you out of the thumbnail.
Yeah. For the whole gang.
The whole gang.
The whole gang's there.
That's why you're front and center. You're right in the middle.
Do you guys have any other news that you could think of?
Nah, the Sony one was the only big one I got.
So yeah, like for instance, like I love the 1917 one. So I had the little hat on.
I like the Richard Jewell one that you guys.
Yeah, I love the reaction reviews because.
Yeah, Scale's just in the background.
Yeah, he's just like, hey.
Well, Matt's there too.
Well, no, I know.
Well, Matt's Sam Rockwell, isn't he?
Mm-hmm. No, I'm John Hamm.
Yeah. But you just look further away, which is funny.
And I love how Connor's Ray. Ray.
Oh, and his big cheese.
Connor hates that picture. I just know it.
We still need to take those pictures, goddammit. Yeah. Talk about Bad Boys.
Bad Boys for a minute.
We didn't even talk about Overwatch. I see
it
right there.
No, I just threw it up there because Overwatch 2 has been confirmed.
It's great. Really?
Yeah, it was confirmed a while back.
Okay.
Yeah, they're gonna have a story mode, multiplayer mode, obviously.
No.
Honestly, I would pick it up if like the single player is like actually like they've a big thing. If it's not like a Call of Duty campaign, if it's like an actual in-depth story.
Hey, that's an insult. The Modern Warfare in-depth campaign was amazing.
I think we can all agree that Ghost had the best campaign. Son, are you okay? Talk to me. Okay, just head to this location.
I can't believe that the main character never talked for years in Call of Duty games. It made no fucking sense.
But you see what I mean. I would love Overwatch, big story, because they have countless like little movies.
Short films, I never really know where to find
reveals,
those.
Right?
So it's like I'm not really big on the story, I want to know more about it, but
like that's
like,
where you get a lot of the information on these characters.
Yeah,
also and just, the lore.
I think it's just kind of dumb how they just keep kind of pandering to the LGBTQ community a lot. Soldier 76 is gay. Okay, but does that really matter? You know, like.
Well, I think it's kind of dumb when you say it just to say it. Because you don't say, this guy's straight.
Yeah.
But if you see him, like, kiss his husband on the forehead before he leaves, then it's like, okay.
Yeah.
All I need. It's not, it feels like you're J.K. Rowling being like, did you know that Dumbledore's gay?
Yeah, that's what I mean. It's just like, I feel, well, maybe Overwatch just does it in a better way, but sometimes they're just.
It's lazy screenwriting, storytelling, when you tell us stuff about the character. Yeah. Show us stuff about the character.
Mm-hmm. But anyways, Overwatch 2 is coming out. You know, story mode's going to be included.
Mm-hmm. I'm really curious how they do it, because Overwatch is still one of the biggest esports games out there.
Yeah, I mean.
And it's been out for years.
Yeah, Blizzard knows how to make them.
Blizzard, yep. Can we get a StarCraft movie? Blizzard, please.
So, Bad Boys for life.
For life.
I guess spoilers, but I wish I just remembered the jokes a lot more than.
It was a really funny movie.
You're going to jail. You're going to jail.
Nah, I'm retired. She knows. She always knows.
There's a lot in this movie. It's like a fast-paced movie.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's just, I did not see, obviously he wasn't going to die, but Will Smith just getting fucking shot.
Yeah, so soon.
Like three times.
Yeah, I didn't see that coming.
For a second, it was like, did we just kill him? Like for a second, I was like, wait, no, there's a lot of scenes that I haven't seen yet.
Getting PTSD from seeing the few scenes from Godfather when you guys were watching it. I thought he was going
to... no spoilers.
And Will Smith is just...
People die in that movie.
Well, I know. I don't know just who. Saying.
It's a movie about Sonny the mafia Corleone and dies. There's a Tommy gun.
Okay, well, I'm not going to watch it now. Just tells me everything I need to know.
But yeah, like I did not see that coming, and it was just kind of like, who do you think would have won the race? It looked like Will was winning.
Nah. Martin Lawrence was getting his second wind.
Yeah, and then he gets shot. And
dude, also nice gun choice, P90. Good design.
I do like it was like when the one villain uploaded the video on the dark webs.
Oh,
And but like the whole like the new Arrow team were just ammo. They were just watching, and the, like the guy was like pressing, trying to press the space bar, and like couldn't do it. That was pretty
big, man. I'm gonna need you to hurt some people. I'll pay for the therapy. Thank you. I'm going to need it.
I wish he was closer so he could be there.
Yeah,
that was funny. He was.
There was definitely quite a few good jokes, but not a lot of them were as totally memorable. But I mean, you know, just for a dumb, fun action January movie.
I'm gonna touch it.
I forgot.
I'm gonna touch it again.
Or when they go to the spa and he's dropping the baby off. And
yeah.
He's just like, oh, I'm closing the door.
Drive.
That was great.
I did like that because they then connected it to the second movie and was like, on a scale of 1 to 10, how mad are you? When I broke up with your sister, we don't talk about that or something like that.
She's about a 9. Oh, man. Well, you better chalk it up to a 10 because I forgot the baby wipes. I love Martin Lawrence.
It sucks he's retired, but I'm happy for him. Good for you.
Yeah, he deserves it.
Hopefully. Well, I mean, there are like in talks already of Bad Boys 4.
Oh, my God.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Well, honestly, I would be okay with it, but you don't need to bring back Will Smith and Martin Lawrence. They're done.
I really think so.
I think so. I feel like, well, Martin Lawrence, he's done. You know, he's kind of chunky. That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
Will Smith could be the mentor with the really hot lieutenant acting as the captain. So I would be okay with it.
I would like them in. Like I would still like Martin in the universe. Maybe he's retired and he's in like one or two scenes.
Yeah, just cameos.
Yeah,
but like, yeah, like this is the new three, and
Will Smith is just like their handlers, or he could be the handler to his son, because he did talk to him at the end, and he's like, you know, how about we try cutting your sentence down a little bit if you do this stuff for us?
Yeah, they left it wide open.
Because I mean, his son is pretty fucking. He knows a thing or two about martial arts. And
here's my thing though.
He could be an anti-hero. Like, don't totally make him a good guy now.
I think he might actually be. I don't know. Like, the switch was kind of dumb. God, how he was just. I mean,
I kind of wish he died.
What, as far as, like, how his attitude changed?
Yeah. I mean, like, I can understand the fact that he felt betrayed by his mother and was used. And, you know, the fact that she lied to him about who his father was.
Right. Because it makes sense. It's different because he thought Will Smith. Well, no. If Will Smith knew that he had a son, then that change probably wouldn't have happened. But Will Smith didn't know.
Yeah.
So you can't be mad at a father figure for not being there when they don't know.
Yeah.
I'm going to bring this up, though, because you said that you don't want Martin Lawrence and Will Smith. They're going to be in the movie, and they're probably going to be the main stars, because I don't think anybody's going to see this movie if it's these three new people.
Yeah.
I just think that such a dynamic duo of these two that if you make a Bad Boys 4 and these two aren't on the front cover, people aren't going to go see it.
I feel like if it's just Will Smith, they could still sell.
Yeah, I feel like for marketing reasons, they'll show Will Smith, maybe Martin Lawrence in there.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like they're going to go like a G.I. Joe retaliation route where it's just like, you know, Channing Tatum's in this movie.
But then look how that movie performed.
Because he fucking died within the first fucking 20 minutes.
Spoilers.
For a movie that came out like 10 years ago.
Yeah.
We're getting a new one, apparently.
Yeah, apparently.
I was so fucking hyped for that movie because G.I. Joe, fucking amazing. It was so goddamn good.
I need to watch those again.
I've never seen him.
G.I. Joe, the first one, was pretty good. I mean, it was decent. And then Retaliation came out, and you're just like... So Channing Tatum's going to come back at the end of the movie, right?
Nope, he's dead.
He just fucking died. And I'm just like, what the fuck?
He's in like an iron lung from SpongeBob. You remember that?
No, he just got blown up.
No, I meant like if they brought him back, it's just his head out of the body. Like this machine.
Or like Futurama characters. Like they just has like little fish jars.
This movie was good.
Good. I enjoyed it.
I really want to go back and watch the first two. I keep saying that, but they're so good.
There's a lot of the violence, like the dude getting impaled by the spike.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Like the lever thing was really good.
Get him an ambulance. He's fine.
I think my biggest issue was, like, you brought the pacing up before. The first act was all over the place. It was just, like, building tension back down, up, down, and then, like, Will getting shot. And then they rushed this whole, like, oh, man, I'm feeling bad for him. Is he going to make it? And then we jump back to, like, this wedding. And then it's like, we were supposed to, like, get this, like, dude, emotional impact in, like, 10 minutes. It's like,
I totally thought Will Smith was gonna fall when he was giving his toast, because like he stood, he was like in the wheelchair and he stood up and he was perfectly fine, like he didn't have to be in a wheelchair at all. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I just thought like the whole like, I was like, was that the best way to get these characters back into the solution? Because right. like the dude got shot like 3 times in the stomach and chest, like, mm-hmm. and he was perfectly fine after that. That would take years, and this movie said like 6 months.
We don't know.
I thought it said 6 months.
Well, no, yeah, six months, but we don't know the recovery. Have any of us been shot in the stomach?
3 times? I think the fucker would die.
But it's also just like,
I mean,
he wasn't.
Where did he get hit?
He wasn't also. He wasn't also fully recovered. Mm-hmm. They made that very clear.
Yeah.
When the girl came and visited him and she's like, are you even healed? And he's just like,
But then like the rest of the movie, and it's a dumb action movie, so you just put that behind you. Yeah. But like.
That's why it's a January movie, because they're just moving it along for the story.
It's the cameos. We didn't really get to talk about them. Michael Bay as the wedding host or whatever.
Yeah.
That was really cool. Was great. Man, wouldn't that be cool if that was Michael Bay and credits? Oh, shit. That was Michael Bay.
It was really nice that he's on good terms with it. It's not a situation where, like, I don't want to make it. I don't want him to make it. Blah, blah, blah.
Was Hobbs and Shaw the one that had Kevin Hart in it?
Mm-hmm, Kevin Hart as the air marshal, yeah. And then Ryan Reynolds as the other agent dude.
That was really good.
Oh, yeah, Ryan Reynolds. Yeah.
Then totally
Hobbs and Shaw
spoils
was a good movie.
Game of Thrones at the end. Totally spoils.
I totally forgot about it, so.
It's okay.
It's okay. Tony Stark dies. I looked at Mitchell and I was like, well, shit. I guess it's okay. This show's.
It's okay.
It's okay.
It's okay.
And then you had.
I just remembered.
What's his name?
Oh, Jon Snow's Aegon Targaryen or something like that?
No. The other cameo.
Oh. Who? Ryan Reynolds.
In fucking Bad Boys.
Oh, DJ Khaled.
Yeah.
DJ Khaled!
I didn't know we were going back to Bad Boys. This was all over the place.
I'm so mad that they didn't say another one. Like, that was such a great opportunity. Just, another one.
Yeah.
Another one. Dude, that would hurt so much. Did you get pig fat on my suit?
I love it, like, the fear in his eyes when he's realized
he's
it.
Like, shit, I'm dead. But yeah, it's a fun movie.
Yeah.
So.
Legend says that DJ Khaled is still handcuffed to that table to this day.
That'd be great. That'd be great if like there was like one more end credit scene.
Did you guys hear about the story of DJ Khaled getting lost at sea on his jet ski?
Yeah.
He was live streaming. He's like, it's getting dark. I don't know where I am.
That'd be terrifying.
Right?
Couldn't even imagine just being lost at sea. Fuck that.
On a fucking jet ski.
I mean, at least it's not like a surfboard. But
did you guys ever follow him on Snapchat?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was kind of fucking dumb. He had like this little statue lion. And he would like go out and water his grass every day and his lawn and flowers and stuff. And he'd be like giving some advice. And he'd turn and you'd see the lion. And he would spray and be like, lion! And just spray. And I'm just like, why the fuck do I follow him?
I like how humble that DJ Khaled waters his own grass and garden. He doesn't have a.
He's got a cook, though.
Dude, I would hire a fucking cook. Make me some nice ass shit every night.
Yeah.
Did you want to spend hours cooking and doing dishes?
Or enjoy nature and just water your plants for a minute?
And splash some water on your lion.
Yeah.
Where did he come from?
He's a producer.
Where did he come from, though? Like, what? Yeah, I remember.
Purple Lamborghini. Yeah. No, that's Rick Ross. Damn it.
I drove by Rick Ross's house the other day. What's up?
So basically, we're
fucking
best friends.
Huge.
Yeah, we're moving next week, so.
Was Skrillex there? Did you see Skrillex's car?
I saw a purple Lamborghini.
Really?
No.
Damn it.
My headcanon is ruined.
Does anybody have more to say about Bad Boys?
I would definitely revisit it.
The women were very attractive.
Oof.
Ooh.
Yes!
Yes.
Vanessa Hudgens is getting a divorce. Hop on it, boys.
Yeah, she probably 30. Saw herself in this movie. She's like, fuck it. I'm single. I'm going to get a divorce.
That's why she did
it. I still got it.
She got that side braid. Was amazing.
She probably saw that new one chick and then she was just like, fuck. Can you not
Are you
fuck
breaking
with the mic?
Everything?
I'm not breaking anything.
Tighten it.
What new chick?
Tighten it.
Oh, the ammo the head captain. Lady?
The new captain?
Yeah.
The slick back hair.
She's. I looked it up.
God,
the
yellow dress.
The villain and her are from like a ton of Spanish stuff.
Fuck. looks like it's time for me to learn Japanese.
Shut up.
And I saw a commercial for, I think it's like the Rob Lowe EMT show. I don't know. Some TV show that the yellow dress chick is on now.
Fun fact, Rob Lowe back in the 80s went to court and married a Georgia for having sex with a minor.
Rob Lowe.
Any videotape.
Jab Lowe. Start it over?
Chad Lowe.
Start that sentence over.
Rob Lowe, back in Jablo. The '80s, was at a party in Marietta, Rablo. Georgia, and Jablo. Had sex with a 16-year-old and videotaped it.
Rob Lowe.
How old was he?
I don't know how old he was, but it was consent. She knew she was being videotaped, yet she sued him, saying she didn't know he was being videotaped. He won the lawsuit.
How?
Because
expensive lawyers.
I don't know, but. I just learned that last night.
What was the age of consent back in the '80s in Georgia? 16?
16, yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's why, yeah. Okay, yeah. Okay, so that's why, like, they were... It was.
You're doing great things, Georgia. Stay classy.
But that's my fun fact for
I
the
think
day.
They raised it to 17. That close.
what you looking up, Matt? What you looking up? What meme are you going to do?
Just keep talking.
Nah. I'm a tie.
Well, the next thing I'm going to do is like...
Tell me twice, I remember it exactly. Chop low, Rob low, Chad low, Chop low, Rob low.
I love this episode. Chop low, Rob low,
Chad low. He's great in Parks and Rec. He's a fun character in Parks
and Rec. If anybody was curious, that was American Dad, the episode where the cyborg Canadian Stan Smith comes to the present to steal Francine and go to Hershey Kissland? Yeah, Hershey Kissland.
Hershey.
Jake has been there. I've never been.
Of course you
have. Great Christmas vacation.
Also, Jacob went under the alias of Augustus.
What are we up to, boys?
Yeah, let's do a closing
statement.
What
have we been doing this past week?
We have been streaming together.
We
have found a good couple games for us all.
Sadly, maybe you guys already talked about it.
Oh no.
Our footage. Our quality got default settings, so it doesn't look the best. So now go ahead.
You know how like we have different accounts on OBS? Like I said, I have my account, yours, and now Adam Evo. My settings for my account don't automatically go over. So I haven't changed the settings for you or Adam Evo yet, so it's just...
Honestly, I probably won't stream with a face cam until we move into a bigger area, just because, you know, whatever.
But it just sucks that like the quality could have been better. So like this next time around, it's gonna be.
It's okay. And I think I like this setup. I think we will do Twitch highlights on Thursday, and then be like, "Yo, if you like these highlights, tune in tonight for the next stream."
That's a really good idea.
That's a really good idea. And also, we were talking about it today when I was picking Matt up. Since you have Sunday night, we should also just stream Sunday night.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So we can do two times this week. Special.
Yeah, because I might have to work. I don't know, because my work schedule might be changing a little bit. We can talk about that later.
Also, we got to find time to go to Amanda and Ariel's this week.
Yeah.
We'll figure it out. Anyways, that's part of the podcast. I kind of said it earlier. I have just been playing the fuck out of Skyrim. Like, I'm about to go play again, like, when you guys go to work and be playing for the next 6 hours.
Oh, you got to go back. You're only going to be here for like half an hour.
Like 2 hours.
Really?
Yeah, my pickup started at 3:30 and go till 5.
Okay.
But yeah, so I've just been playing Skyrim, kind of playing it. I'm going to hold off on buying the Kingdom Hearts DLC. I kind of want to see how the community likes it.
Really?
I just don't need it right now.
Mm-hmm.
So, but I do want to, I just want to see how people are, if they're liking it, if it's worth it. And then if it is, I'll probably buy it like right away. If not, I'll probably be like, you know what? I'll just wait a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But because I've just been playing Skyrim, so that's kind of like my game right now. Matt's been
I've been in a weird fucking funk, guys. I don't know what the fuck's going on with me. I don't have the gumption to play games.
I like that word.
He bounced between like three games within like an hour.
I can't find a groove.
Yeah.
Well,
that's how I was until I got back into Skyrim and
seeing you play Skyrim
in between Civ and Skyrim.
I'm not even just gonna pop Skyrim in.
You got to complete that Pokédex, man.
I'm working on it.
Because you got two trophies left for Rainbow Six Siege, and you've just been... I've been watching him the last like 2 days, and it's one of those games where like, if you just die the stupidest way, you just rage quit. You just turn it off. And then you're pretty much over Ghost Recon. Are you going to visit it again, or do you think it's over?
I don't want to talk about that. It's such a waste.
He also kind of rage quit on that.
After seeing Matt's rage, I don't ever want to see you just silent mad, because that's another level. If you're just...
It's more of like a big disappointment. Like when Matt like gets bad food at a restaurant, like I'm he's not like mad. Shit. Like he's like,
I'm disappointed.
He's mad. Like
when I'm not mad, but I'm just like,
when's the last time you got bad food at a restaurant?
The one that I'm thinking of was the one in time that we went to Buffalo Wild Wings before we all went.
Was it the same one?
No, it was the one on Barrett.
Shout out Barrett. Don't go to
beat up Fairly. Awful cellular service down in Barrett.
Yeah, why?
Yeah, I don't know.
Why?
But I've just been kind of using this. I've been kind of like in a more TV watchy mood.
We do have to finish a lot of TV.
Yeah.
We need to catch you up on My Hero.
Caught up on Ozarks.
Oh, season 3, March 3rd, I think.
Fuck yeah. I thought it was like late March.
Maybe 27th.
I saw three in there. Ozarks is all caught up. I'm super excited for the next season. It's going to be great. Finished Castlevania seasons 1 and 2.
Ooh.
Finished up The Irishman. Finished up... I don't know.
We should probably watch Castlevania.
I did. We watched the first 3 episodes so far.
The Outsider. Super excited about that. It's really good so
far. That episode was a little slow, but it's okay.
You guys should definitely do a reaction review on that. I probably won't watch it, but it's still good content.
I thought the third episode was kind of fine. I didn't really care for the introduction of Holly. She kind of, I mean, has a weird way.
Yeah. About her. Nothing about her as an actress. The character, I think, is just kind of hard to adapt to screen.
Yeah.
So I don't know how she's going to be handled in the show. But
what's the guy's name? The guy that Russ's character plays?
I have no idea. But yeah, he's definitely the most interesting part of the show right now. So.
Big things and changes are happening with him.
Yeah, watching that, I gotta get caught up on My Hero. I'm definitely gonna do that this week.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, dude, My Hero. Oh my god.
Yeah, you guys can't say dude. Shit.
That's.
You guys know episode 76.
It fucking got me.
It.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, it got me.
Ooh. Okay, I'm looking up.
Like it's probably like the most. United States of Smash is pretty fucking dope, but like. It's up there. It could be better than that.
I'm super excited to see what the rest of the season is going to hold.
Yeah, Matt still needs to get his spoiler out of the way.
Yeah.
Hmm. Okay. We never do it. What's the code word for this podcast?
Oh yeah. Nah, I'm retired.
There you go. Nah, I'm retired. Do it all in capital letters down below. Emphasis on the nah.
Also Ray My Martin Lawrence.
What?
Voice? Interpretation?
Not interpretation.
Impression?
Yes.
Yeah, impression.
I can't fucking think today.
That's okay, bud.
You got gumption. That's all that matters.
I have gum.
So comment down below. Nah, I'm retired.
I better see that comma.
Nah.
After nah. You need that spacing. It's not nah, I'm retired. It's nah. I'm retired.
So without further ado, guys, this has been a news and video game.
And a short one.
Yeah, nice. Short sweet,
we don't want to do 2 hour plus podcasts.
An every
hour
week.
Is good.
So
could have been shorter, but
this has been Andrew.
And Caleb.
And Matthew.
Peace.
Bye. You're welcome.